Alright, hello, welcome to my little review slash demo on the application for your iPod or iPod Touch or iPhone called AirMouse. It goes back, called AirMouse Pro in the store. I think it was like $6, but I mean, for the price, it's probably one of the better apps I've used yet. Let me move that out of the way for a second. So what you have here is it has a keyboard. It's got a nice, the touchpad works almost perfectly. And then, so I'll go ahead and show you it on the internet. So let's open Firefox right here. I mean, the touchpad on it's pretty much identical to the MacBook touchpad. So let's see, I'm going to go to YouTube. Search. And I'll give you a little, so you click right here. What you do is you just type in, what am I gonna watch? Let's type in Julio Jones, wide receiver for Alabama. So what you do is you press return, and it presses it in where you have it. So let's press enter again, and it does that on the thing. So, and it's got this nice little scroll wheel right here. But what I like doing is I like flipping it over. And what you do to get the keyboard up is you kind of like, you swing it a little bit, and it comes up. It doesn't always do it perfectly like you just saw. And then get rid of it again now. So, what I like doing is I like just using this and then using my two fingers to scroll down. What should we watch? Sometimes it gets a little hung up, but it's not that bad. So which one should we do? I see it lags a little bit sometimes. Alright, so let's just click Julio Jones, first one. Right, I don't know why it's lagging right now. Let's go back to this. A little full. You can just pause it real quickly. Scroll down and go ahead and post a comment. Alright, so I'm not gonna actually press that, but this thing, you can see it goes in there like that. But now the feature that's probably the best on it is this. So it looks like a regular mouse, but what you do is you press on this middle button, and then you tilt it. I mean, it can't detect side to side. You have to tilt it, but it works very well. I don't think there's anything that works quite as well that is similar to this. So what should we do? Alright, so the precision on this isn't perfect, but I mean, it works really well, so you can just go up. Let's try to exit out. See? And it just clicks just like that, so. I mean, that's basically all there is to it. You can just pull up the keyboard there. Oh, and there's also some other features on the keyboard. You press a little button right there, and it brings up. I'm not sure. Oh, there we go. Press that, it brings up the Google search. What does this do? When I press home, it never actually goes home. Then you can also go to your, like, see, I have Quicksilver set to F6. You press F6 and it brings up Quicksilver. Then you would type. But I'm not gonna do that right now though. And then we'll see you can also pause and your play your iTunes and stuff. Let's go ahead and open iTunes up, and I'll show you a little how that works. So movies. Let's go to music. Alright. What should we listen to here? Let's scroll on. Pick something random just by scrolling. Stevie Ray Vaughan. I'm going to just do it with a little wing. It's pretty good song. because you would, whatever. I'm a little in trouble here. Double click on it. There you go. So this is a little Jimmy Hendrix version. So then you can also... It doesn't actually bring up the Apple volume. It just brings up... So you can see little volume up and down buttons. Mute it. Not actually kind of numbers. Go to next song. Alright, so I guess I've gone through all the features on it. Now you can also scroll like that, I guess. That's how you like it, but I'm not going to bore you too much with this app. It's a very nice app.
I was rambling on there. I was just about to go look it up in the App Store, which is kind of stupid, so I just cut it off. But it's a really great app. I highly recommend it to anybody. Just if you like this video, subscribe, and there'll be more like it coming up soon. Thank you.